Hey guys, how's it going? Today we are going to do part two of my Nordstrom anniversary sale haul. I will link part one down below and in the cards up here for you guys if you want to go watch it. In that video, I talk about some tips and tricks on how to get some of the items that are really popular or are sold out or are limited sizing. So if you want to know that information, then go check out part one. As a disclaimer, I'm gonna send a lot of this stuff back. I'm hoping you guys can help me with some of that. Either if you have these items, if you have similar items, things from the same brands, tell me what's good and what you don't like. So far, I have a pretty good opinion on what I want to keep and what I am going to send back, but I feel like there's still a few like stragglers that I'm not sure. So let's get started. I'm gonna start with the more randomy things first. I only have a couple things and then we are going to do clothes. So the first thing is this necklace. This is just a little tiny dainty necklace. It has a gold chain and then just a little tiny like disc right here that has some little cubic zirconias in it. It looks really cute, nice. Like I said, just dainty and like delicate. This was actually a recommendation from my friend Danny. I will link her channel down below, but this looks so cute. She was wearing it in her video, so I picked this one up. And then the other random things are beauty. So I got the beauty blender set in here. You get two beauty blenders and a little case that's cute and sparkly, and I love this mint green beauty blender in there, so I'm excited to use these ones. And then I also got a NARS face palette. This was a recommendation from Madison Miller, I think, and it's in the shade, I don't know how to say this, so I'm just gonna write it down here so I don't say it ridiculously, but she said that the highlighter in this was really, really beautiful. You get a highlighter, a blush, and then Laguna bronzer. This blush looks a lot like Orgasm without like the chunky glitteriness to it, so I'm a little bit disappointed that it's not a more like a different palette. I feel like I have Laguna so many times over and I have like a pinky kind of shimmery blush like this one also. So it's kind of a bummer, but I think the highlighter is beautiful and that was really one of the main reasons that I picked it up. Look how pretty that is. I love that. The outside packaging is also really cute. So I'll play with this one. I'll let you guys know how it works out. Okay, moving on to clothing. Let's start with shoes. So I got a couple pairs of wedge sneakers. I have been really intrigued by these. Marnie from Miss Gold Girl, she talks about the Caslin ones all the time and they look so cute on her. So I picked up some Blondo ones because these are waterproof and I love Blondo for their waterproofness of their shoes and booties, and I have quite a few pairs. These ones they sent me in the wrong size, so they'll for sure be going back for maybe an exchange, maybe just a return. So they have an elastic panel on one side. The wedge in here I think is 2 inches and they have a zipper on this side. The color is much more gray than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be more like a little bit more brown neutral. They also have a blush, a black, and a leopard, which I believe all of the sizes are stocked. Now the downside of this shoe is that it's not very comfortable. Blondo, I think, needs to work on their comfort level with their shoes because all of the ones I've tried, they're not terrible, but they're definitely not comfortable. Luckily, I did pick up the Caslin ones, which I talked about in part one of my haul. And you can see these are really similar shoes. They both have about 2-inch wedges in there. These ones are more brown. This is what I expected the Blondo ones to be like, the color. You can see it's a subtle difference, but it is more of like a wearable shade for me, this one. And overall, I like the design better. I think I'm going to stick with the Caslin ones because these ones are very comfortable. I've been wearing both of these around the house and like I said, the Blondo ones aren't very comfortable. I think I could definitely manage if I was going to be wearing these or wanted to wear them in like a wet environment. I think I could make it work, but I'm not planning on wearing them like when it's super wet. I'm hoping to just wear them when it's dry. So these are great if you need a waterproof version, but if you just want a little bit more comfort, I think these are also a little bit cuter. They've got some little perforations on the front. I'm gonna stick with the Caslin ones. They're very, very comfy. Shoe number two is from Lucky. It is this year's version of their wedge booty. Now they had one last year, which I have here because I bought it last year. It's really similar. You can see the V on here is a little bit more intense and this one is more subtle. So overall, I think that I do prefer last year's a little bit more. It's really nice and elongating on your leg. But this one is also cute. It's a really pretty rich brown color. And the thing that's really nice about these ones is they are waterproof. And I feel like at one point I saw on the website that these said waterproof. And then later I went back and I didn't see it. So maybe I just didn't read it. For some reason I thought at one point these were and then I thought they weren't. but they do have a little tag on them that says the suede is waterproof, so that's really nice. And Lucky also has another booty with a shorter heel that's also waterproof, so I will link that down below if you guys are looking for a waterproof suede booty. This is a really pretty color. They have in tons of colors this year. Most of them are fully stocked still, so you can go check those out. I know last year, this version, everybody loved it. It sold out like crazy. It kept getting like restocks and people loved it. So this year I haven't heard people talk about these ones as much. So if you like the style, I think you'll have really good luck getting your size and a color that you like in these ones. And last for shoes, I got a pair of the Vince Camuto peep toe booties. I love Vince Camuto booties, and usually I get a pair or two every year during the sale. So this is this year's version. I did try to get a pair of the regular booties that everybody loved. I think they're called Gigietta. And I ordered them multiple times. When I ordered them, I want like the record to state, when I first ordered them, they had every color and every size, and I ordered them and they got canceled, and then I ordered a few more times and it kept getting canceled every single time. So I was never able to get my hands on them, but I did want the one in the tortilla color. Really, really cute. So if those come back in stock, I might eventually pick those up. But these are the booties I got this year. The heel on this one is a little bit different. It's more of like a slimmer heel. A lot of the times it just goes straight down from the edges right here. This one's a little bit slimmer on the bottom. You can see that. And then it's got all these little laser cutouts. Now, the thing with this shoe is where it kind of like slopes down, the laser cutouts on the side here kind of like pop out a little bit. I'm not sure if you can see that. I have to show it to you on my foot, but they pop out a little bit and it doesn't lay like flush against your skin all the way down, which I don't have a problem with, but I'm kind of a klutz and I have a bunch of kids running around and I'm doing kids stuff. So I feel like this is just an accident waiting to happen. I think that this is going to get snagged on something, and then because the cuts are so fine, the laser cuts, it's going to just like tear off a whole section of suede, and I'm not gonna be able to fix it or make it look normal. It's just gonna be like a ruined shoe. So I think I am going to return these. If you like this booty, I think it's super cute. If you like it and you want it, I do think it runs a little bit big. I always get a size 8 in my Vince Camuto booties, and this one I got an 8 and it's a little bit big. So I would say go half a size down. Okay, so now let's get into actual clothes. For my Barefoot Dreams cardigan this year, I got the circle cardigan in the shade Rosewood. This was a color that I haven't seen other people wearing or talking about, but it sold out super quick. So I don't know if it was just really limited stock or if a lot of people got it and they just haven't been mentioning it. I'm not sure, but I ended up having mine canceled. Happened with a lot of my things. A lot of things got canceled. So I was only able to get a size medium. I'm hoping that eventually the extra small smalls will come back in stock so I can exchange this one for my right size. But look how pretty this color is. I love it. This like deep burgundy maroon is one of my favorite colors, and I wear it really often. So I was super excited to see this color. Of course, super soft. The circle cardigan has pockets. They also had some other really nice cardigans this year. They had the, I forget what it's called, but it's like a drapey one. And in the past when they've had drapey cardigans, they don't have pockets. This year it has pockets. So that is also a really, really good one. They had a couple others too. The Moonlight pajamas from the Nordstrom lingerie line are some of my all-time favorite pajamas. I have so many pairs of these. This year I got two pairs in this really beautiful mauve color. Look at that like flow. They're so flowy and soft. They're thin enough that you're not gonna get too hot at night in these. And they did have a shorts version. I got the long sleeve and long pants version, but they had short sleeved and shorts if you like that. And these are just so nice and comfy, so super soft. I just wear them all the time, especially the pants around the house. If these are a little bit pricey for pajamas for you, Target also has a close dupe. This is a really nice soft modal fabric. You can get something really similar at Target. I will link it down below. That's also a modal fabric. So if I'm not gonna buy these from Nordstrom, then I buy the ones from Target. I can't remember if I already mentioned this or not, but I just had a baby. So right now I am bigger than I want to be. And so most of the things I bought in my pre-pregnancy size, because I know that I'm going to be losing weight in the coming weeks and months. And so I wanna make sure that I have things that fit me well. come fall and winter time, and so some of the things don't fit me now, but they will eventually. So that being said, let's talk cardigans, lots and lots of cardigans. So this year they came out with this long line cardigan from Leith. They usually have a Leith cardigan in the sale, and they're usually really, really big hits, and I think this one was as well. So I got a couple colors. It is still flowy, it's really nice, but the thing I like about this one is the weight of it is really nice, where even now where I'm like, I have like too many lumps and bumps where I don't want them, if I put this on, it just like lays so nicely against my skin and it doesn't emphasize or show all those bumps and lumps that I don't want people to see. So I love that. And this draping on the front here also lays really nicely when you have it on. I just feel like something about the weight of the fabric and the design is so perfect and so flattering. I'm short. I am 5'2", and this is a long cardigan, so it goes down like to the very bottom of my knees. For some people that can be a little bit overwhelming, so just note that's how long it is. It does have a really nice flattering slit on the side, but no pockets. So I got this really pretty pink. If you guys have the cardigan from last year, it's the exact same color as the one from last year. And then this one is called something fudge, burgundy fudge or something, but it's really like a deep chocolatey brown with just like the tiniest little hint of burgundy to it, just enough to make it a little bit warmer. It looks black on camera, but it's not. It's a really dark brown. And then I also have this green one, which I love. Next cardigan is from Halogen. This is the exact cardigan that they had last year, and I got like 4 or 5 colors. It was my favorite cardigan. This one is similar to the Leith one. It's a long line cardigan. This one is a thinner, more like fine knit material, almost like a thick t-shirt material. So it's lighter weight. It's going to be really nice for like summer nights or, you know, mildly cool days, or if you like work in an office or you're gonna go see a movie somewhere, it's gonna be a little bit chilly, but not super chilly. This one's going to be awesome. It is also not quite as long as the Leith cardigan. So if you are short and you don't want something that's going to be overwhelming, then you could try this one. This one goes to the top of my knees, and it also has pockets in the front. And this one is super, super soft. It's very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? Like pleasing against your skin. It doesn't feel itchy at all. So I got a burgundy one this year. I was on the hunt for a burgundy cardigan last year and I couldn't find one. So this one is terrific. And then I also got this pink one. Let's see if you can see the true color. It's kind of hard to see. The pink one is really pretty if you're looking for a light pink cardigan. I'm going to return this one because I actually got a pink one last year that is just a couple shades darker than this one, but a very similar color. These are my favorite cardigan to wear every day. The Leith ones are nice. I feel like in comparison, the Leith ones almost feel a little bit scratchy, and because they're longer, like I said, a little bit overwhelming on me. But in the end, the Halogen ones win, and these ones are my favorite cardigan. This year I only got 2 pairs of jeans, and they're both from the brand Good American. So this is the first pair. It's just a dark blue, a little bit of whiskering right here, but no distressing, and it's just a skinny jean. So my favorite kinds of jeans are almost like the ones that make you feel like you're wearing leggings. You know, they're like a thin material and they're really stretchy and nice. That's how these are. Look how stretchy that is. That's so nice. And even the waistband is stretchy like that. It's not like a thick, you know, like super constricting waistband. The pockets are nice pockets. I didn't even check that till just now. Sometimes, you know, you get jeans with like the little baby pocket that's almost nothing. These ones look like good pockets. So these are size 2. On the website it said to size down, and so I pre-pregnancy I wore like a size 4 or a size 2, and I feel like looking at these, like, I don't think these would fit me even when I was like the skinniest I ever was. So I think I need a size 4. So I think I'll exchange these and then hopefully they'll fit once the baby weight's gone. But I've heard really good things about the pocket placements, and I just love the color of these ones. So I will link the exact pairs of these jeans down below because I forget what the actual like name of the color was. And then the other ones that I got are these ones. And actually these are size 4. So let me show you the comparison with the waistband. So the dark ones are size 2 and the light ones are size 4. So that is the size difference right there, in case you're wondering. But these ones, you guys, these have the same stretchy material, stretchy waistband, stretchy legs. These ones have distressing on both knees right there, and they are flares. if you guys have been around for a while, if you watched my videos from last year, you'll know flare jeans are my jam. I love flare jeans so much. I bought some last year. I know they weren't super popular, but I bought some. I talked about them. They're flattering on me more than skinny jeans are, and it could be because I have like big calves. So if you have a skinny jean and your calves are big, it just looks like a big calf. Anyway, I love flares. I am super excited to wear these. I am a little bit nervous because they're a bit long for me, so we'll have to see how that goes. But if you're looking for some good flares, I would definitely recommend these ones. Like I said, stretchy, soft, thin material. I am so impressed with this brand. I definitely want to try more from them now that I've tried these two. Let's move on to jackets. I have a couple. So this one is probably my most favorite and the one I'm the most excited about. This is the Blank NYC faux leather drape jacket. I love the Blank NYC jackets. I usually buy one of them every year, and this year I was super excited about this one. I think this is still in stock in the red and the gray, and then a couple sizes of the black one. But you guys, this is so gorgeous. It's like almost suede-y on the inside. There's no lining because this is just like a super thin lightweight jacket. So I saw someone, I forget who it was. If I can think of it, I'll link it down below. But they took this jacket and they like wadded it up into a ball, and they could hold it like in one hand, like in one palm, because it's so lightweight. And I'm probably going to be moving back to a hotter climate soon, and so lightweight jackets are going to be awesome in the fall and winter time. And I just love how pretty this is. I love the asymmetrical look. I think it's so slimming and so flattering on me. I love it so much. You can see that's what the back looks like. And then all of the edges on this one are like raw edges, so there's no hemming on the sleeves or the bottom or the collar. It just is so pretty. Look at this. I honestly wish they had it like in a dark brown color. That would be so gorgeous. But this one I'm super excited about. Can't wait to wear it. Next we have this faux suede one from Cut From The Cloth. This one has also been super popular. I ordered it in the tan color. I think it's called Buff. And that one has not arrived yet, so it will be here soon. I also got it in this really beautiful burgundy wine color. I'm not sure which one I'm going to keep. I was leaning towards this one, but now that I have it here, I'm not sure how much use I would get out of it. I'll probably use the buff colored one more often, but it's a beautiful coat. This material is just like really nice and soft. I don't like jackets that are like stiff and constricting. This one is going to feel so nice, and you'll be able to move in it. Has these beautiful details. The sleeve right here has a zipper. These are like a black gunmetal color, and it's the same with the one in buff. It has the same color hardware on it, so you can see it's kind of like an asymmetrical zipper, and then all of the zippers are that same color. Really pretty, and I love just the softness of it. You see that? Like, I love that so much. So I'm excited for this one. I'm excited to get the buff color, and then we'll see which one I'm gonna keep. I got a small in both this one and the Blank NYC jacket. This is the last jacket that I have, and actually this one might be labeled as a blazer, but I'm gonna call it a jacket because that's how I'm going to wear it. So this is the Caslon Drape Front Blazer Jacket, whatever you wanna call it. You guys, this one is where it's at. This is so inexpensive. I think it's like $30 or $35 on sale. It is a really good price. And the awesome thing about this is it looks structured. It looks really nice and chic and put together, but this is like a sweatshirt material. Like, this is like cozy and comfortable, but it gives you that like almost like office or put together vibe. So I love this so much. Can you see how pliable it is? It's like a sweatshirt, and it has these really cute, like, they're not exposed seams. I don't know what you call it, but it has them on the back too. This is the stitching on the back. So pretty and so flattering with the stitching right here. It's like I don't know what this is called. I'll have to show you close up because I don't know what to call it. But this is beautiful. The drapiness is so flattering. This hemline is really nice and slimming. It also has pockets, which is a plus. I love when simple jackets or coats have pockets. It's a really big pet peeve when they don't have them. So I love that it does. And this comes in a million colors. I already ordered a couple more. I think I ordered a yellow, a maroon, kind of like a pinky color. And they also had I think the white one is completely sold out, but keep your eyes open if you want the white one because it might come back in certain sizes. They also had a navy and a black, and I think a couple other colors I'm missing in there. But this one is just so nice, and I know that it's going to be one of the jackets that I use all the time. This green color is going to be so, so pretty in the fall, so I can't wait to wear it. I have been talking for who knows how long, and I just looked up at the camera, and it wasn't even recording. So I don't know where it left off. I don't know where it stopped. So I guess I might just have to re-talk about everything to make sure that I get it all. So we're going to start with the best of the best because it's the best. So this is the Caslon plaid shirt. I talked about this corally one in part one, but since then I got in this beautiful blue and white plaid shirt. So I wanted to mention both of them and show you guys the colors. There's one more color that's like purple and yellow. It's super busy and not really my style, but these shirts are amazing. They are so good. I bought all of the colors from last year and then two of the three colors this year. So you know they've got to be good. So the thing that I love about these is they're super soft and cozy and flowy, but the fit of them is really nice. It's like a semi-fitted fit, and so it doesn't look too boxy. It makes you look like you have a shape, and on the bottom, the hemline is rounded, which is my favorite cut, and it's also more of a tunic's length, and the back is longer than the front. So you see that right there? That's the difference. So it's going to cover up your bum a little bit, but in the front, it's still going to be a little bit long if you want it to be longer in your front. So I love that. It's so drapey and nice, and I like that these are a little bit more form-fitting. So again, these are the two colors. I bought all of the colors last year, and these two colors are my favorite. So I'm super excited to wear these. They are really, really nice. I got mine in an extra small petite, just because I like mine to be a little bit slimmer fitting, and the petite because the arm length is perfect on me. So I love them. You guys need these if you like plaid shirts. They're so affordable and so nice. Next for plaids, I have these two from Treasure and Bond. I was really drawn to the color of these ones. I saw a few people modeling them and they looked so beautiful. So this one is a lighter shirt. It's got some it's like a brown burgundy color running through it, and then this really beautiful classic red one. This is a boyfriend cut. I think that's actually what it's called, is a boyfriend plaid. And so it's a little bit, I don't want to say boxy because it's not boxy, but it is wider, and I think this is the smallest size they had, which is extra small, and I could wear this now if I wanted to and it would be fine. And like I said, I want to lose a significant amount of weight, and so I'm hoping that, you know, as I do that, these will still look nice. But a lot of the times when I wear oversized items, it just makes me look bigger. It makes me look like 10 pounds heavier. So I'm hoping these will look okay as things go. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to give myself a deadline, in 2 months, I need to try it on and I need to either decide if I want to keep it or send it back. Nordstrom does have a really fantastic return policy, in case you're not aware. They are really, really good with returns. There was one time I had something for 9 months and forgot to return it, and I called them and they were like, yeah, no problem, just ship it back to us, and they have free shipping back. So they have a super, super good return policy. This one is awesome because it is long, and then it's longer in the back than the front, which is, of course, one of my favorite things, because then you can wear it with leggings, and it just, I think these would look super cute with leggings. Can you imagine these with dark leggings would just look so nice. Even this one, I think, would look cute with the Spanx faux leather leggings, because it's kind of shabby chic almost. So I think these are really cute. I'm hoping they'll fit me well as time goes on. I picked up one of the basic BP striped t-shirts. I also got the one that was white with black stripes, but that one got canceled along with everything else in my other orders. So this one I got just a nice basic. It's a V-neck, which I always find really flattering. Now this one is a fine t-shirt. I feel like it is a little bit wider and shorter, so I'm not sure if I'm going to keep it. This one is an extra small, but I really do like shirts to be tunic length is perfect for me. I like it to cover up my bum, and I just feel like it's flattering on my body shape when it is a little bit longer. So this one I'm not sure if I'm going to keep or not. But a basic that I do love and I am going to keep is this one from Halogen. This is one of their Modal t-shirts. I'm trying to put on a hanger because I threw it off the hanger. This is one of their Modell t-shirts. This is super flowy. Can you see that? I love it. Again, a V-neck, super nice basic, but it is crazy long. So again, you can wear it with leggings. It just looks really nice. The back is a tad bit longer than the front, and then there's a slit on the side. This one is an extra small, and it is a little bit like bigger than what I would think an extra small would be like. But again, it's just going to add to that flowiness because it's a tunic length and it will cover like your hips and stuff like that. These are my favorite. I have a ton of these Halogen Modal t-shirts from years past, and I didn't see any other colors in the sale. So if you know if they had more colors, let me know. They may have sold out before I found them, but this one is fantastic, and I just love the Halogen Modal t-shirt. This is another Halogen Modal t-shirt, but you can see this one's more of just like a basic crew neck, and then it has long sleeves. These ones are perfect for wearing like underneath a jacket or a cardigan because the sleeves are so slim fitting, but also have almost like a slickness to them that they're not going to get like caught up in your shirt or add a lot of bulk to your jacket or cardigan or anything like that. So I love these shirts for that purpose. They are thin, flowy Modal again. This one they had in several colors. They had like a white, a pink, they might have had like a tan, and a striped version. I do like to have the darker colors because if I'm going to wear it super form-fitting, like the white one is probably going to be a little bit see-through. This one is not as long as the tunic red one that I just showed you, but it's still a really good length. But overall, this one is supposed to be more form-fitting all throughout the body, where the red one is supposed to be a little bit more flowy. And both of those ones are extra smalls. I can't remember if I said that or not. Okay, a Socialite Thermal. This one was a hit last year. It is such a cute thermal, super soft. Again, like a notched V-neck right here, super flattering. And I love this color. So this year, I think they had a black, a white, this really pretty maroon color. And they also had like I think they called it tobacco, and it's like a yellow mustard with like a tinge of green in there. It's really cute. I just grabbed one because I think I got 3 last year, and so I just wanted to pick up one more in a new color. So I like to have mine more form-fitting because of the added bulk when I have things oversized, like I said. So this one's an extra small, and I just love it. Like I said, super soft material, very nice. Again, if you want it to be oversized, it's flowy, so it's going to be really nice and drapey on your body. And then very last, I got a set of the Barefoot Dreams cozy socks. They had a 2-pack this year, and I gave my mom a pair of these socks last year, and she loved them, so I wanted to get a set this year. And they had this color, and they also had a duo that came with, I think, like a white one and a light pink one. So I picked the gray set, and they feel so nice and soft. So I can't wait to use these. That is everything that I have received so far. I still have a few little straggler packages that haven't arrived yet, but this was the bulk of it. Again, you can check out part one for those tips on how to get the harder to get items and how to find your right sizes and things like that. There's some good information in that one. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and it was helpful. Have an awesome day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.